Hey there, how are you? This is Brenda Adelman. You're on stage and on camera visibility and storytelling coach. How are you today? I'm gonna give you a few tips because it's kind of breaks my heart. What's happening out there for entrepreneurs that are not getting their business going, not expressing themselves, not making sales, not letting their ideal clients know that they're out there because they feel fear around doing videos. So I want to give you some practical tips. I want to tell you how I can help you make your videos this weekend, like have major transformation. And also why I started teaching this a couple of years ago. I started teaching it because I've been an entrepreneur since, I don't know, 2005, something like that. I started coaching in 2005. And then I started doing my online business around 2008, 2009. Created my first online course in 2014, 2015, in addition to being on stages all over and having a background in acting. And what happened is when video came in, I was teaching storytelling, I was doing my own one-woman show, performing all over the place. And I had a lot of coaching colleagues, experts in their own right, that were just not showing up as who I knew they were. I knew they were badasses. I knew they were bold. I knew they were leaders. I knew they were experts. Even for my introvert friends, I knew they were real experts at what they were doing. And then I'd see their videos and I would be like, I have to help these people because they're amazing. Their work needs to be out there in the world. And why should someone have to do take after take after take after take and then still not be any better than they were when they started, but then they just put it out there. And then there were all these like teachers that would say, you just have to go live, just go live. But they looked bad. So they're losing. Don't just go live if you don't have skills. Please don't do that. Get the skills you need. I run several free challenges during the year so that if you don't want to invest in yourself money-wise or your money's tight, you can learn that way. You can watch my tips. And then this weekend I'm doing my fourth since COVID started, my fourth video makeover weekend retreat because 2016, I think, is when I put together my You on Video program, but it's 4 weeks. Major transformation of my clients who have taken that. I've run it live and also done it do it yourself. And then when COVID hit in March, I think April was the first one, I was talking to friends of mine and colleagues, acquaintances who were in business, in real estate, like other businesses that I normally am not necessarily working with, that were literally going to go out of business because they could not put themselves on video. Not that they could not, but they were scared to because they knew, actually they knew themselves and they knew they didn't look good. They knew they weren't presenting their best self. And here's the thing, the market is saturated. So if you're not being yourself, being able to say what you know because you're in your head and you're thinking, what am I saying instead of connecting with the person on the other side, your ideal clients are gonna go. They're not gonna come back. Everyone's busy. Everybody is busy, right? And so what I did is I said, well, what could I do? How could I condense the time? And what I realized, and it came to me, some of my programs literally come to me in meditation, and those are the ones that are just my ideal clients just come directly to me, and it's so amazing for everybody. And this was one of them. I did my first video makeover retreat weekend. I think it was like, it was, I know I did them in April and May. One might have been in June, maybe the first week in June. And 2 days together, where you get three videos done, you're going to get, because I'm doing one this weekend and I know it's very late notice. I already have two people in there. You are going to get my eyeballs on your videos in a very safe place. So you're not going and posting in public. No, you're not doing that. You're not posting in public something that shouldn't be for public consumption. You're in a rehearsal space, like us actors have rehearsal space in our group, but you're not also going blind. You're not blindly going, okay, I'm just gonna talk right now. I'm gonna just tell you what I have to say or read the teleprompter so that you look robotic and you're monotone. Like I can't even tell you how many people that I've even listened to like podcasts that are so boring. Not the content, the delivery. There's too much that we have to do to be boring in your videos or in how you're presenting something, because the great material will be lost that you have. I remember this woman invited me to listen to her podcast. It was someone new I had met, and I went to listen, and it was so boring. I couldn't listen to the whole thing, but her content was freaking great. But she didn't hire me. She didn't ask me to give her a critique, so I didn't, but I know it's not going to last. I don't want that for you, because everyone I know, and hopefully if you're here and you're listening to me, it's because you have something to give in the world. You have a message. You have a program. You have something that you can teach other people that's going to make another person's life better, whether it's to help them make money or help them heal from something, or a technique, or a marketing or something like that, or, you know, some of my clients sell things, or realtors, things like that. It's like you have something to give. You want to present your best self, and it's not your fault if you sound boring. It's not your fault. Most people didn't go into business so that they could be on video. Oh my God, it was the opposite. It's like they wanted to be behind the scenes, like crew versus talent is what they'd say in acting, right? So I developed the 2-day virtual video makeover weekend, because also what I've decided is I have a lot of products, but I don't want you to get caught in getting one of my do-it-yourself programs and not doing it. No, I want to actually be there as a coach to encourage you. And not only that, but cut down on your learning curve, right? So in the weekend, this weekend, you're going to get my Charisma on Camera training, 5 days of training. I'm going to help you figure out what to say in your video in a really concise way that grabs people. They know what they're going to get and they'll want more. Going to help you with some acting techniques so that you're looking right. Here's a technique I'm going to give you right now. Okay, whether or not, hey, Tony. Oh, and there's Tony. I just shot her over a video, and she said it helped her so much, the techniques that I gave you in the video that you did, which was amazing that I saw. So I'm just sharing about this weekend. It's very powerful. The weekend is designed so that you can have 3 videos done, whether that is one video that you do that you perfect and you use it on your website, or you use it in your marketing, or for those of you who are coaches, you use it in a part of a 3-part series, or you're creating your first online course, because those are all things that my clients have done. Mark, who's in real estate, he did his first live stream, got over 100 views and comments so that people knew he was in business. Martine did his first online video to go with his first online course so that his personality was there, because sometimes when we're filming on our own, we can be monotone or the personality like goes, but it's not your fault. You didn't learn. You probably weren't in acting classes in New York and London and Los Angeles like me, or acting all over the world. It's just a different skill set. Like, I started with acting and then became an entrepreneur. A lot of people I know are entrepreneurs, business people, and then they have to learn to develop these skills. If you are the face and the brand, if you are the brand, if you are the face of your business, these skills can only help you. So what I teach, which is specific to me, is I teach acting, and I'm gonna give you a tip. And not fake, acting's not fake. I teach you to be authentically you. Because you know when you remember in the olden times when you would go meet people in person and you resonate with certain people, you do business with certain people because you like them, because you have similar interests or values, or you entertain each other. You need to bring you to video so that through all the noise on the internet, people connect to you. And then, of course, storytelling is my specialty after sharing my story on stages all over the world and on over 150 podcasts, radio shows, TV shows, including NPR and Fox TV News. There's a bonus training this weekend on how to tell your story in a way that really moves people and makes you memorable. I'm not even going to tell my story right here, right now, because it's not pertinent to what we're talking about. All I'll say is it's a big tragic story. That why it sticks with people is not only for the fact that I was able to forgive something that was unforgivable, but the fact that I can look and be happy, joyful, a leader despite everything I lost in my life. But I work with you to work on your story. What is your particular story the circumstances of your story that makes your story everybody's story. I mean, I'm teaching a class right now. We have a showcase in about a week from now with amazing students that aren't doing video. They're learning the craft of storytelling. One person, two people are working on a piece that's going to go toward a TED Talk. And it just so happens, since the way of the world is all virtual now, they're also learning how to tell their story on video versus stage only, because we're doing a showcase, so I'm directing them. But I digress. This weekend, we meet in the morning for 9 a.m. call, Pacific time. Everything is recorded. We meet in the afternoon for the second call of the day. There is a private Facebook group for us to, for me to take your questions and to get even more training. You post three of your videos based on what I help you with on that first call. I'm gonna help you articulate which video you should be starting with. So you could have three different videos that you are proud to present in the world, in your marketing afterwards, or you could just make one amazing video. Like I had one client doing her author video for her author page. Like, you choose what it is. If you're selling a product, it could be that I'm helping you to tell the story around the product or your big why, so that people relate to what you are doing in your life and you capture them with your emotions. Okay, so there's a storytelling training. There's also an extra training on how to use your voice. And then we do the same thing on Sunday. And I'm giving you my personal feedback on each of those short videos, 5-minute videos. I'm giving you personal feedback in addition to the exercises you're getting so that you know what to say. I'm going to post afterwards the kind of breakthroughs you can have from the weekend. So I took my 4 weeks of a program and condensed in 2 days to give you as much as I can. And most importantly, you are accountable, because if I hear from one more person, I'm so busy, so I couldn't get to what they actually tell me is important to them, I'm gonna pull my hair out. I know everybody's busy, and it is crazy. I mean, obviously, people, you know, kids are home, you have to homeschool, there's all kinds of crazy things, but I would like to say that there's always kind of crazy things. What is important to us, we make room for. So I designed the weekend so that the other excuses can kind of go away and you just know you have to focus on yourself and have big growth in just 2 days. So that's the weekend, the Video Makeover Retreat weekend. And let me give you a tip or two here right now, which Tony, you know this tip because I shared it in that video that I gave to you. A lot of people, okay, you know you're supposed to, well, some people actually don't know this. You're supposed to look into the lens, into the circle, okay? On the computer, it's into the circle right there. If it's on your phone, it's also into the circle. On the computer, you're not really supposed to be looking at yourself. It's not terrible. If you look at yourself because you need to have that connection, it's fine. Just remember to keep bringing your eyes up. So hopefully you can see this, even the subtlety of it. I'm looking at myself, and now I'm looking there. But here's the next step that a lot of people don't know. Most people don't know. It's just because of my particular history and my acting and all the headshots that I've done. So here's looking at the camera, which is okay. That's better than looking at me. Here's looking at the camera. And now here is looking through the camera. I look through the camera, and then I am really, really, hopefully piercing into your computer, into your room, and you're seeing me like I'm there with you versus, and it's very subtle, just stopping the energy at the camera. Okay, that's my exercise for today. Let me give you one more. But I hope if you are thinking about the fact that you want to do more videos, or this also is another thing I know from my coaching friends, they don't show up for interviews they have. Or they don't apply. Sometimes they do apply and they don't show up, because I actually know, you know, people who run podcasts that are also often on video, but even just podcasts, they say that a lot of people don't show up. And I happen to know, because I'm talking to people, that it's because they get insecure. They're afraid of, like, first of all, if it's on video, how are they going to look? And then they get insecure of, like, how are they going to speak in such a way that it's interesting and they don't want to be caught off guard. Well, what if you could work on all of that this weekend? Because you can. That's what I'm saying. You could have a big breakthrough so that you could start getting more, booking yourself more interviews and things like that. So what was the other thing that I wanted to share? Okay, let's just share something about looking good. I'll do a lighting tip. A lot of people know this, but some people don't know. Oh, and the thing about looking at the camera, a big mistake people make when they have their phones. When you have your phone, if you have it sideways, people are looking at themselves. And because of where the camera is, it makes you look like you're looking to the side. So even though it's really uncomfortable, you actually have to look to the side. And when you look to the side, which looks like, which feels uncomfortable, it actually makes your gaze straight so that the person on the other side feels like you're looking at them. Okay? I think that's it. I think that's good for today. I'm going to post a link to the program. If you have any questions, let me know. This is like, it's as low as I could do it where I'm still valuing my time, because I want you to have breakthroughs like my clients have, and I want to spend the weekend with you. I'm a fierce coach, but I'm also fun. This is a time where I love the connection I have with my clients, and even though we're on Zoom, it is the next best thing to being in person. And the way I teach, it's about being yourself, all of yourself, the flaws, the fabulousness, everything, standing in your power. So that is the virtual video makeover weekend. This weekend, I hope to see you in there. And if you have any if you have any questions for me, let me know. And hopefully those tips were helpful. Okay. Let me know if you were here. Definitely. Even if you're watching the replay. Okay.